part one we have seen that two type of fibers we are having all around us, that is natural fiber is there and synthetic fiber is there. So in that one only two natural fibers we are going to concentrate in this particular lesson, that is the fiber obtained from the animals. So animal fibers only we are going to focus in this particular lesson. So we can see that the wool is nothing but it is a animal fiber, isn't it? From where we will get the wool? See, from sheep, camel, some type of goats who are having, they will also give the wool and the yarn. So these four animals are there who are from whom we will obtain the fiber, that is natural fiber of wood. Nowadays whichever the cotton, we can say woolen clothes we are wearing, woolen sweaters, socks, like that, everything, that is another one, blankets, everything that is prepared from this wool. So how this wool we will get from the sheep? Maximum, even though all these animals are giving the wool, but 99% we will get the wool from the sheep only, the different type of sheep. So getting sheep are rare. To get the wool, that is the only one purpose for which the sheep is rare. So because the shepherds are getting, they are having more and more advantage for rearing the sheep, and they don't have to do any extra or any hard work for rearing the sheep. Sheep is herbivorous or carnivorous? Herbivorous. So what is the food of the sheep? What is the food of the sheep? What the sheep is going to eat? Grass or leaves. And you can see that the shepherds are taking hundreds of sheep and they are rearing, they are grazing here and there. So they don't have to waste the money, they don't have to spend the money for giving the grass and leaves to the sheep. Means the almost the food the sheep are having, that is they will get from their surrounding only. That's why you can see that the shepherds, maximumly the wool giving sheep we can see anywhere. Nowadays you can see that sheep we cannot see in your home. Goats are there, isn't it? But sheep, they are reared purposely. The shepherds are having thousands of sheep. So you can see that the even though the sheep, you can looking that all sheep are looking same, but not like that. The sheep are having different type of varieties in that one. So if to same type of sheep, if you want a particular type of wool, they have to be breed. Breeding means what we can say, the mother should be of good quality or the father should be of good quality. Any parent, if it is of good quality sheep is there, then whatever the wool given by the sheep, that one is good quality. Now you can see that the mattresses or pashmina shawl, like that one, they are having the amount, or they are having the that one cost is too much costly, that one is, and that is also they are giving from the sheep. But regular wool, what we are using for sweater knitting, that we cannot use there. So in sheep also they are having variety of sheep. Who will give? Some sheep will give ordinary type of wool, and some sheep will give the extraordinary quality of wool. So yesterday in previous class only we have seen that under the skin they are having very fine type of hairs. That hairs they are using for preparing the small, very fine type of clothes, fine jackets, very soft. And the pashmina shawl, like that, they are too much costly. They are having the cost in lakhs also, that much. That's why the shepherds who are rearing the sheep, they are in a very good condition. They are too much rich, because we have seen that after every three four months one sheep is giving nearly 5 to 6 kg of woolen. So how that one? In previous class we have seen that it is not just the upper layer of the hairs, they are having the long hairs. Why this? They are having they will grow automatically. According like us only, if you are going to cut your hairs, automatically the gray hairs will grow. No, they will not stop growing. Like that, the sheaths, once the hairs shaved, again within 2-3 months, again the fibers grow and they convert it into the wool. Automatically that will going on. The process is going on until that sheep get die. Means lifelong, what sheep will give tons of wool. Means see how much the shepherd is rich. You can imagine. And that sheep is eating everything that is free only. The wool given by the shepherd, they are selling that one, getting too much money. Means they don't have, what is the cost? What is the effort they have to take? That is only shaving the wool, or we can call it as a fleece. Fleece is nothing but it is a upper layer of the skin. Means how the hairs we will, if it is grown very long, we are going to cut like that. Same shaving of the fleece is called. That's why different processes are there. Once the fleece or the hairs get shaved, of again the sheep becomes very much active. You can see that the sheep, some of the sheep are having too much weight. They are very much fat. What is? Because the sheep woolen grown or the fibers grown on their skin is too much. Once it is shaved, means once again that sheep, the fibers started growing automatically. The too much woolen will be grown on their skin. So there are different processes to get the fibers to wool. The fibers are grown on the upper layer of the skin of the sheep. How it will be converted to the wool? Directly wool will not grow on the skin. Fibers are grown. That fibers of this fleece get shaved or cut from their skin. And after that it is converted into the wool. To get the wool, there are different type of processes are involved. Firstly, initially that all processes are done by manually. The human beings are doing that one. Nowadays for every process we are having, or the human being is having, the machines ready for doing all the work. See, initially the skin removing, skin is not removed, only fibers are removed, upper layer of the hairs are getting removed. It will not be shaved like that. Skin tankano shave madangila, only the upper part will be trimmed. So that one is nothing but it is, so they are having different processes are there to get the wool from the fibers. Fibers we will get from the sheep's hairs. How it will be converted to the wool? So there are different processes are there which are going to involve. At the end of this class, after 10-20 minutes, we are going to share one video. In that one you will get all the processes clear. How the process will be going on one by one. At the end product is nothing but the wool. Lastly, we will get the wool, whichever you use for knitting the sweaters, for preparing the woolen cloths, rugs, blankets. So like this, which process, on which steps are involved in the process to get the wool? So like this, you can see that. Have you seen the sheep? Seen the sheep? How they are very thin, like this, then how they are? Very fat. They are fat by themselves, or on that, on the skin, the wool fibers are grown. Haven't they seen the sheep without fibers? No, always. Once it gets shaved, again from tomorrow, next day only it started growing once again. That much fast growth they are having. So that's why the sheeps are kept in a different place. The sheeps who are there in the mountainy areas, they are having long hairs. That is beneficial for them. Benefit for them. Because you can see that in the Himalayas or Himachal Pradesh, the snow is falling. Isn't it? So if imagine the sheep without the thick fur or thick fleece, if they don't have, what will happen to that sheep? The snow will directly, the temperature will directly attack to their skin. And due to that, the skin, the sheep may be die. So the upper layer of the skin or the fibers, they are going to protect the sheep from the harsh conditions. that is there in the Himachal Pradesh of Himalayas. So the sheep get protected. So the different process which are involved to get the wool, that is first step is nothing but shearing is nothing but the removal of the fleece from the sheep's body, the sheep's skin, whatever it is. How slowly you can see that in your the fathers, they are going to shave daily. After 8 days, if they not shave, what will happen? The small hair has started growing. Like that, if the sheep is not sheared or not the skinny, if it is not removed properly or if not regularly, if it is, the sheep becomes too much fat or it becomes heavy, the skin becomes, the fibers becomes too much heavy for them. So after three months or 4 months, the fleece or the, you can see the fibers are removed regularly, either by the hand, they are having, how the barbers are shaving, no? Like that, they are having manually, they can do like that. But nowadays, there is a machine to remove the fibers from the sheep's body. The process of removal of the fibers from the sheep's body is called as a shearing. What this process is called as a shearing. So once the fleece is removed or the fibers are removed, you can see that the sheep is roaming anywhere. Is it that the sheep is sitting in one place only? No, they are for grazing purpose, they are roaming anywhere. So in that, whatever the hairs or the fibers cut by after shearing, what is the things present in that one? Maybe dust is there, isn't it? Maybe some insects are there. Maybe that fleece is so much dirty, isn't it? Because sheep is sitting anywhere, sleeping anywhere, grazing anywhere. So some dust is present in that one. Some insects are present in that one. So if you want these fibers to be converted into the wool, these dirty fibers we cannot directly use. So we have to make them clean, or we have to make them dust free, wax free. Wax means little bit of oily structure this fleece is having. So to make them clean, or to make them very white and white, see here, first of all, this wool is present only in three colors naturally. Naturally, wool we will get in three colors only. Either it is white, either it is black, or maybe it is brown. Naturally, we will get the wool in these three colors only. Then how the sweaters are colorful? How the sweaters are colorful? You can see that the sweaters are in different colors only, shedding only. Wool is not giving that shade of wool. Only sheep is giving either white, either black, or either brown. So the different processes are done on these wools to get the colorful wool. Yes, chemicals they are using. They are dyeing that one. That step will occur after this one. Okay. So the step one is nothing but the shearing. It is nothing but it is removing the fibers from the sheep's body. Next step, scouring. Scouring is nothing but the removal of the dust or the flax or wax from the fleece, because that fleece is too much dirty, colorless. Because you can see that sheep is roaming anywhere. Maybe that skin get, the fibers get dust, whatever it is, unnecessary things are there. So what they will do, they will dip that one, that fleece, in a type of water. That fleece will be kept in that one, and once that one stirring, after stirring, what will happen? The dust will stand on the water, and at the downside, you will get the clean fibers. So that process is called as a scouring. First of all, initially, this scouring is done by the human beings. They are putting that fleece into a big tanks, stirring like this. After that, they will remove again. They will make it dry. After drying only, it becomes, we will get the clean fleece, free from the dust or flakes or wax, whatever it is, from insect only. Nowadays, this scouring is done by the machine. Once this dirty flake, dirty fibers are put in a machine, it will automatically clean all the things, and the clean and clean fiber will be obtained by the machine. Means nowadays every step we can do by the machine. That's why the sweater making factories, the woolen cloth making factories, they are very profitable, because every work they can do very fast. Previously it is not possible. That's why see here the one example I will give. Then from that one you will come to know how the work. If your mother, grandmother, sister, or any of your in-laws have you seen that they are knitting the socks or sweater by hand? The needles are there, big needles are there. From there, they are knitting that one in a different designs. Okay. So take this and take the example of another sweater which is prepared in the factory. There is a huge difference. There is a huge difference in both type of sweaters, both prepared from the woolen only. Then also there is a huge difference. What it is? The handmade sweater, we can see that sweater becomes little bit loose. Thread we can see directly, the woolen we can see directly. But the factory made woolen sweater or socks, you can see fine stitching is there. Designs are done very fine. Handmade sweaters, little bit difference is there. One design is big, one design is small. Like that, there is a difference. So both are wools. And nowadays these sweaters are also made in the factories. So the second step which is involved in that one, that is nothing but it is a scouring. After that one, what will happen? Once we get the dry fleece or dry fibers, that one should be only in three colors. Is it possible that only three colors of sweater we can wear? No. Nowadays you can see that hundreds of colors are there, thousands of colors are there, thousands of designs are there. So for that purpose, you can see that there are three types of, after this scouring, you can see that different type of fibers are separated. Some fibers are long, some fibers are very small like this one, some fibers are very fine, some fibers are very hard. So that should be separated for preparing the different cloths. That is nothing but sorting. What do you mean by sorting? To sort means what? To differentiate. To differentiate means we have to sort that one in different categories. Long fleece or long fibers get separated. The small fibers get separated from after this scouring process. And from that one very fine, the small threads are there. Or small fibers from that one woolen cloths are prepared. From the long wool, we will get the sweaters, socks, mufflers, caps, everything we can prepare. Shorts also. So like this, after sorting the fibers, then only it is possible for the manufacturers or the factories to prepare the different items from that particular. Now it is wool or it is fiber?
Fiber.
Yet it is not converted into the wool, because now it is also in the fiber process only. After that one, once it gets separated, that's why you can see that some of the sweaters, once you wear, the small threads will come up from that one. That is nothing but they are the small fine fibers. Once it is washed, if you are washing that one, the small threads will come out from that particular sweater or woolen cloth. Daily if you are wearing, that's why here the woolen cloth should be kept in the cotton cloth. After the winter season, you have to wash that one and you have to keep in a woolen cloth. Because if it is kept outside with a, if anything by the atmosphere or by the weather also, threads are grown up. Some fibers are getting loose by the weather condition. So after that one, you can see that after sorting only, there is a cleaning of burr. burr is nothing but it is a fine or soft fibers. These fibers are separated after the sorting, and these fibers we are using for preparing the woolen cloths. Sweater is a different and woolen cloths are different. Have you seen the woolen cloths? No, they are prepared from the very fine or very smooth like fibers, not cotton cloths. Woolen cloths are different and sweaters are different. Okay, so cleaning of burr, that means this process is done after the sorting. And after that one, the next step which is involved, that is nothing but the dyeing. Dyeing is nothing but it is a coloring, giving the color to the fibers. That fiber should be dipped in a different colors of tanks, like red, blue, yellow, pink, orange, whatever the color you want, you can prepare in that one. In that one, the long fibers which we have separated, that should be dyed. Dyeing you know, all of you? Coloring the hairs, that is called as a dyeing. Like that, the coloring the threads or fibers is also called as a dyeing, giving the colors to the long fibers. And after, once the it is color is given to that one, after they will make it dry. In the machine only everything is going to be happen. So once it will get dry, that should be rolled. That fiber, once it get rolled means it is ready for the use, or the use for the next step, like preparing the sweater, preparing the shawls, preparing the sweater, socks, mufflers, everything. Gloves. Now this,
gloves.
So the variety of cloths we can prepare from that. Okay, the fine shawls are used, fine fibers are for using for that one also. So that different processes are involved for preparing. Just once, first we get the fiber. After that one, by doing all these processes, finally we will get the wool. See here, fiber we get from the sheep. Sheep is a herbivorous animal, isn't it? At the last, after using too many chemicals and like that, whatever the wool we will get, that is becomes natural or artificial. Initially, that wool which is prepared, every step they are doing manually only. At that time, no chemicals are there. Everything is done by the natural. Natural colors are also there. For example, okay, have you know the beetroot? Beetroot vegetable, isn't it? Even though when you start cutting that vegetable, what will happen? Your hands become red, little bit, isn't it? So even though if you are going to wash that one, after some time also you can feel that the hands are reddish on it. Means in that particular vegetables we are having the natural colors. Even though you can see that the beetroot juice is there, beetroot juice, you keep one piece of beetroot on any one paper and remove that one, the color will remain there only. So some initially the people are using the natural colors to dye the wool. Too many from vegetables we will get the green color, isn't it? So like this, initially all steps are going on manually, so the wool we will get, that one is good. But nowadays everything is done by the machine, and at the end they are using the chemicals for dyeing purpose. So now the wool is not natural, not artificial, like that. Semi, we can say half it is natural, half it is artificial. So like this, now if concept is clear, now one video I am going to share here, from which you will come to know how the fibers are converted into the wool.